Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to your online class. Today we'll discuss about the last topic, dispersal of light. Today class prism, public chapter 5, light. Okay. Already we have discussed about the topic dispersion for a single light. When a light passes through a glass film, it will deviate from its path. Okay, when it emerges out from a glass prism, okay, that is called angle of deviation. Clear? So when a white light passes through the glass prism, okay, inside the glass prism it will split into the seven color, okay, seven constituent color, okay, clear? And after emerging out from the glass prism, we can see these seven colors on a white screen. That is what? Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. Okay? Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Clear? So, when this white light emerging out from the glass prism, it will split into the seven colors. And each color of the light or the wave will deviate from its path. Okay, original path. This is the original path. Now, this is the original path. This white light. So deviation takes place from each color of the light. But which one is maximum deviate and which one is minimum deviate depend upon its wavelength. So here, red light. The wavelength of the red light here. It is maximum. The wavelength of the red light is maximum. So it is minimum deviate. Minimum deviate. Wavelength of the red light is maximum. Wavelength, you know? Wavelength, length of a wave. One complete oscillation. Already we have discussed about this in previous classes in sound chapter. Okay, class 7. We have discussed about this. So wavelength of the red light is maximum. So it will deviate minimum. And wavelength of the violet light is minimum. Wavelength of the violet light is minimum. So it will deviate maximum. Means maximum deviation takes place in violet light and minimum deviation takes place in red light. Okay? Depends on the wavelength. Which color of light have minimum wavelength? Minimum wavelength, that is maximum deviate from its original path. This is the angle of deviation, del R and del P. The angle between the original incident ray, light ray, and emergent ray. So this white light is deviate maximum because its wavelength is minimum as compared to red light. Clear? And this red light that is having maximum wavelength is deviate minimum. Its wavelength is maximum. So we can summarize this order of the wavelength and the angle of deviation as here see lambda r, then maximum wavelength, then lambda o, then lambda y. In this order we can arrange. Wavelength of red color is maximum, then orange, then yellow color, then green, and then blue, then indigo, and last white. Here, this is the order of the wavelength. Decreasing order. Maximum wavelength is red color and minimum wavelength of red color. Say we can write that the angle of deviation is maximum for violet color and minimum for the red color, because the red color have the maximum wavelength. So if wavelength is maximum, so it will show minimum deviation. So we can write this order of wavelength for the all these constituent seven color as del V, then del I, then for blue color, then green, and then yellow, as L R. This is the decreasing order of the angle of division. Clear? Okay. Decreasing order of angle of divisions. And here also decreasing order of wavelength. So maximum wavelength, that is the red color, having red color, and minimum violet color. Okay. Maximum angle of divisions having violet color, and minimum angle of division having red color. Clear? So finally we can conclude that when white light pass through a glass prism and when it emerges out and also inside the prism, it will take reflections and dispersion also takes place. So white light is split into the 7 colors. So we can define this phenomenon of dispersion. The phenomenon of white light is splitting into its constituent 7 color when the white light passes through a glass prism. That is called dispersion of light. And spectrum, this band of the 7 color, the band of these 7 color, when the white light passes through a glass prism obtained on a screen, this band is called spectrum. This band is called spectrum. Dear students, usually you can see this activity when you just will take a glass prism. Already I have shown you glass prism in last class. In last class, when you take a glass prism and pass the white light through the rectangular surface of the glass prism, and you will see its division, dispersion on a white screen. What you will observe? You will observe that the white light is split into the 7 color in this order. Okay? R is the minimum deviate and white color is maximum deviate. With your, in short, we can say that this spectrum, we can say clear students. So this is the concept of dispersion and spectrum. So kindly go through this topic through the book and try to understand this topic. Okay students, next we will discuss about the exercise question in next class. Thank you, have a nice day.
Dispersion of white light by a glass prism. You must have seen and appreciated the spectacular colors in a rainbow. How could the white light of the sun give us various colors of the rainbow? Before we take up this question, we shall first go back to the refraction of light through a prism. The inclined refraction surfaces of a glass prism show exciting phenomenon. Let us find it out through an activity. If a prism is placed in a room and a narrow beam of white light is allowed to fall on one of its refracting faces, what do you observe? It is found that light coming out from the other face of the prism is splitted to 7 colors. What are the 7 colors that you see on the screen? The various colors seen are violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. This phenomenon, the splitting of light into its component colors, is called dispersion of light. The band of the colored components of a light beam is called its spectrum. Why does this happen? The acronym VIBGYOR will help us to remember the sequence of colors. We have seen that white light is dispersed into its 7 color components by prism. Why do we get these colors? Different colors of light bend through different angles with respect to the incident ray as they pass through a prism. The red light bends the least, while the violet the most. Thus, the rays of each color emerge along different paths and thus become distinct. It is the band of distinct colors that we see in a spectrum. Isaac Newton was the first to use a glass prism to obtain the spectrum of sunlight. He tried to split the colors of the spectrum of white light further by using another similar prism. However, he could not get any more colors. He then placed the second identical prism in an inverted position with respect to the first prism. This allowed all the colors of the spectrum to pass through the second prism. He found a beam of white light merging from the other side of the second prism. This observation gave Newton the idea that the sunlight is made up of seven colors. Any light that gives a spectrum similar to that of sunlight is often referred to as white light. A rainbow is a natural spectrum appearing in the sky after a rain shower. It is caused by dispersion of sunlight by tiny water droplets present in the atmosphere. A rainbow is always formed in a direction opposite to that of the sun. The water droplets act like small prisms.